As you can see on screen now, these are a couple photos I took at a photo booth at my movie screening, and it was pretty cool to see that because a lot of the times at this theater, they don't really do stuff like that, so it was pretty cool to get to take a picture, get to hold the lightsaber, but let me give you guys my take on the movie. Just really thinking about it for this review, there are some problems with it. It kind of seems like Abrams is trying to make a sequel to Force Awakens while also trying to make a sequel to The Last Jedi, so you kind of get crammed into two movies, but you know what? I kind of liked it. If you kind of just gloss over that, there's a lot of entertaining aspects. I mean, a lot of people say that Palpatine coming back didn't work for them from the very beginning, but it's the exact opposite for me. I figured it would have something to do with Snoke, something to do with Ren, something to do with Rey. From the first trailer, I think it was, back in April of this year? And I did. I liked it. I liked what they did with Palpatine. Just seeing how they brought him back with the Snoke clone, I mean, yeah, going back, watching Last Jedi, Force Awakens, it does kind of, you know, bring Snoke a little down, like, oh, he was just a clone of the Emperor, so we don't really care about him anymore. But, I mean, who else could have they made Snoke? I guess they could have made him Darth Plagueis, but story beat terms, I don't know how well that would have worked. And Ian McDiarmid isn't on fire in this movie. But I think, honestly, probably the best performer out of this whole film, and now just rewatching the movies leading up to this one, the best performer is probably Adam Driver's Kylo Ren, because he gets great setup in Force Awakens, and I think one of the things that made his character so compelling is he was one of the few things that Rian Johnson took in The Last Jedi and just made his character something you want to be interested in. He was like, okay, cool, you know, I liked what JJ did with Kylo Ren, so, you know, I'm gonna continue with it, because it was pretty cool. And then, you're just on a quest, which is pretty cool. You kind of get to see the whole trio coming together, just going planet hopping to planet hopping, and it's kind of a different Star Wars movie, because it's almost like a mystery where, like, you're trying to put the pieces together. We need to find Palpatine, so we'll use this clue to the next clue. And by the way, one thing that I really like that no one's talking about is Hux. Hux was cool that, like, oh, he's the spy, and he was like, no, I don't want you to win, I just want Ren to win. That was cool, until, like, 2 seconds later, he's dead. I was like, what? Like, what? Just 2 seconds later, he's gone? I was also a little upset that Darth Maul wasn't in it. I thought, what was the general guy? I don't know. The general that took over for Hux towards the end. I thought it was going to be Darth Maul, because, like, he was, like, bowing down to Sidious and everything. I don't know. I was hoping that would just Darth Maul, because I'm a big fan of Maul, and, like, they put Maul in Solo, so what? He's just in Solo, so that's just a fan service moment? Like, what? And that's the other thing, too. I think the reasons critics are panning this movie so much is because it's just so filled with fan service. Like, it's fan service. Hey, you don't like The Last Jedi? Snoke's dead? Well, guess what? Snoke's Palpatine. I don't know. you didn't like what I did with Rey's parents? Well, guess what? They were nobody, but, her parents were somebody, the Emperor. I mean, it does seem a little rushed. I think they should have took a better roadmap, and I think if JJ would have directed The Last Jedi, this whole trilogy would be seen a lot different, because Disney originally planned on having a separate director for this film, and I think that would have made it even worse. But I did like what JJ did. I mean, Lando, Billy Dee Williams, doesn't do much, he's fun to see. And Bobo Frick, I don't know, funny. And C-3PO, he has an arc in some of the other movies. I mean, he's the only character to be in all 9 main installment films. And he has an arc. It's like, oh no, are they really gonna do that to C-3PO? But guess what? He gets his memory back from R2-D2. Like, what? And that's one of my other problems with this film. Chewbacca's dead. Oh, no. Like, I don't know. Half hour later. Oh, no. We don't kill Chewbacca. Chewbacca's still here. Oh, no. We didn't take his memory. R2-D2 still got it. Like, what? I like the Ewok cameo at the end. That was pretty cool. Han Solo. That was something I wasn't expecting. Just to see... Han Solo, that moment with Kylo Ren was maybe my favorite scene in the entire film. Because, I don't know, just something about that scene really caught me off guard. And when Kylo and Rey kissed, I was like, oh no, is he taking his shirt off again? Do we need to see this? Is he going to take his shirt off and then they're going to die? I don't know, but like, I just pictured during that scene, like, thinking, like, Palpatine in the background going, do it. I know that's weird, but, like, another guy in my theater was screaming that at the top of his lungs, so interesting time there. And the other thing was all the Jedi voices. I would have loved to see Force Ghosts. Like, the voices were cool, but, like, even the truest Star Wars fan might not have known who all those guys were, because I caught some of, maybe some of the Jedi's voices that slipped under the rug. Kanan from Rebels was in there. I do not believe Ahsoka Tano was in there. And I thought they could have done more with the clones. I thought, like, it would have been cooler if, like, Palpatine made an evil clone array. I mean, obviously, that probably wouldn't happen. That wouldn't go over too well. And the other thing was, Ren's mask was absolutely fantastic. Like, the redesign of his mask, putting it back together, that's a reference to Vader's mask, obviously. But, like, Vader's mask was based on Samurai. And then the Kylo mask is also that, too. So, that was cool to see. Finn, he is really good in this. Everything was so good about it. From Poe, Finn, it's very high on comedy. So, like, the first half's got a lot of jokes. And if there, I know I'm nitpicking a lot of things because I really did like this movie. But to nitpick some things, the first half had a very, like, ha-ha-ha, laughing tone, and then it kind of goes to some Revenge of the Sith dark places in that second half where, like, Rey needs to fight Palpatine, and then all of a sudden, Rey's just running off. It did work for me, though, the whole Palpatine thing, because everyone was complaining, why is Rey so powerful? But, like, you knew she was going to have some connection to either a Jedi, Palpatine. You knew it would be some way. Do I think there's a million directions they could have went with this film? Of course. There's a million directions they could have went with this whole trilogy. I mean, it was good. Do I think it could have been better? Yeah. Do I think it could have been a lot worse? Yeah. Do I think it was as bad as prequels? Not at all. I enjoyed all these films. I enjoy Last Jedi for its story. I enjoy it as a film on its own, but as a sequel to Force Awakens, I hate it. But as its own film, I like it. And as this being a sequel to Last Jedi and Force Awakens, I think it works as just a movie on its own. I don't know, actually. Now just saying that out loud, I don't really think it works super well as a movie just on its own, because the general audience really won't get the fan service stuff, and you really need to understand some stuff in Last Jedi, and then you kind of got that dig in there with Luke catching his lightsaber. I don't know, that got me in the theater. Overall, though, there was just so much in here that really, really added to everything I wanted to see from a Star Wars movie. Everything I wanted to see, I got. Everything in the trailers I was hoping for, I got. It was cool, but, like, the Sith cult, that's just dumb. I don't care if you've never seen a Star Wars movie. If you're the biggest Star Wars nerd out there, admit it. That was just dumb. Like, what? What? there's just like 500 Sith followers, like boo, 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 boo. And I'm a little mad there wasn't a Jar Jar cameo. I was hoping for that. But overall, guys, the film was really good. So if you didn't like it, I understand your point of views. But there was just so much in there, including that lightsaber duel. Like, that lightsaber duel between Rey and Kylo Ren. Like, I haven't heard anyone talk about that. Just watching some reviews on this and reading some. Like, what? That was amazing. Like, the ocean, that was so well choreographed. Like, that was probably one of my favorite parts of the film, as I said earlier, with the Han Solo coming in at the end. We got Luke and Leia's Force Ghost, and then Rey with the yellow lightsaber. I don't know. There was so much about this that I really did like. You got Darth Vader's mask, which should have played in a little more, but I guess it was kind of just there to play in for a little bit of fan service. Didn't really affect the story that much. But overall, I think I'm going to give this movie, I don't know, it's missing a couple story beats. So on the score, I'm probably going to give it a 9 out of 10. So it's an A-. But I really did enjoy it. So if you didn't like it, I don't know, maybe go see it again. Just think about this. And yeah, that's my take on Star Wars Rise of Skywalker.